Now, this is your lecture 10, flip-flops. The output of the digital circuit considered previously are dependent entirely on their inputs. That is, if an input changes state, output may also change state. If input change, then output also change. However, there are requirements for a digital device or circuit whose output will remain unchanged. That means once it is set, even if there is a change in the input level, but the output is not changed. Such a device could be used to store a binary number. A flip-flop is one such circuit, and the characteristics of the most common type of flip-flops used in the digital systems are considered in this topic. Flip-flops are used in the construction of registers. It is used in construction of registers, counters, and numerous other applications. The elimination of the switch contact bounce is a clever application utilizing the unique operation characteristics of flip-flops. In a sequential logic circuit, flip-flops serve as a key memory element. Analysis of such circuits are done through truth table or characteristic equations of flip-flops. The analysis result is normally presented through truth table, state table, or state transition diagram, and also through timing diagram. Conversion of flip-flop from one kind to another can be posed as a synthesis problem where flip-flop excitation tables are very useful. First of all, there are two with the help of NOR gate and with the help of NAND gate. We can build flip-flop. The basic circuit of the flip-flop can be improved by replacing the inverters with the either NAND gate or NOR gate. The additional inputs on these gates provide a convenient means for application of the input signal to the switch the flip-flop from one stable state to another stable state. The two input NOR gate are given as shown here. This is our two input NOR gate. This is our first NOR gate A, second NOR gate B. Our input is R, that means reset. Our input is S, that means set, and the input of V1, it is given to the output of the second stage, and this is the output of the NOR A gate, it is given to the input of the second NOR B gate. Right? This circuit is redrawn in the more convenient way. It is like this. NOR A gate, NOR B gate, R and S. This is your output of this NOR A gate, Q, output of NOR B gate, Q bar. That means Q, it is our Q bar, that means complement of Q. It shows that if the V2 is equal to 1, if V2 is equal to 1, then V3 is equal to 0. If it is 0, then V3 is equal to 1. This is your Q and this is your Q bar. Be understand here, right? This circuit is redrawn here. The flip-flop actually has two outputs defined in more general form, Q and Q bar. It should be clear that regardless of the value of Q, its complement is Q bar. The Q, its complement is Q bar. There are two inputs to the flip-flop defined as R and S. This is your R and this is your S. R and S are the two input. The input output possibilities for this RS flip-flop are summarized as the input output possibilities. That means truth table. This is your truth table, R, S, Q, and action. What is the action? Right? If R is equal to 0, S is equal to 0, second condition 0, 1, third condition 1, 0, and last condition 1, 1. What is your Q? Q, it is equal to last state. For second condition 0, 1, then 0, 1, Q is equal to 1. 1, 0, Q is equal to 0. 1, 1, that means we cannot say question mark. Here, the last is question mark. What is your action? 0, 0. What is your output? Last state. Whatever the last state, whether it is 0, whether it is 1, we are getting the last state. That means there is no change. There is no change in the output. For second input, I repeat, first input 0, 0, then output is last state, that means there is no change. For second input 0, 1, output is equal to 1, output is equal to 1, 1 it is given to the set input, that means the flip-flop is set. For third input is equal to 1, 0, then output is equal to 0, output is equal to 0, but 1 it is given to the R, R means the action is reset. The third one, 1, 1, output is equal to question mark. This is nothing but it is your forbidden. It is your forbidden. We discuss about each and every input, what is your output. So first of all, the first input condition, that means 0, 0. The first input condition, that means 0, 0. What happened? The first input condition in the truth table, R is equal to 0 and S is equal to 0. Then since a 0 at the input of a NOR gate has no effect on its output, the flip-flop simply remains in its present state. That means Q remains unchanged. So there is no change. We are writing here, there is no change in the output. The second condition, 0, 1. The second condition, R is equal to 0 and S is equal to 1, force the output of NOR gate B low. Force the output NOR gate B low. Both inputs to NOR gate A are now low and the NOR gate output must be high. Hence, a 1 at the S input is said to be set the flip-flop. That means action is equal to set the flip-flop and it switched to the stable state where Q is equal to 1, where Q is equal to 1. Now the third condition. Third condition is equal to 1, 0. The third input condition is R is equal to 1 and S is equal to 0. This condition forces the output of NOR gate A low. And since both the inputs to NOR gate B are now low, the output must be high. Hence, a 1 at the R input is said to be reset. That means the condition action is equal to reset the flip-flop and it switch to be stable state where Q is equal to 0, where Q is equal to 0. That means we obvious Q bar is equal to 1. This is your obvious. The last state 1, 1, our action is forbidden. Then we are discussing what is forbidden. The last input condition in the table R is equal to 1 and S is equal to 1 is forbidden. As it forces the output of both the NOR gate to the low state. In other words, both Q is equal to 0 and also Q bar is equal to 0 at the same time. But this violates the basic definition of the flip-flop requirements, because if Q is equal to 0, then Q bar is equal to 1. if q is equal to 1, q-bar is equal to 0. But here, both q is equal to 0 and q-bar is equal to 0 at the same time. But this violates the basic definition of the flip-flop that requires q to be complement of q-bar. And so, it is generally agreed never to impose this input condition. Incidentally, if this condition is for some reason imposed, and the next input is r is equal to 0, s is equal to 0, then the resulting state q depends on the propagation delay of two NOR gates. That means if there is any delay, due to this delay, there is a 1 or 0 or 0 or 1, then the resulting state q depends on the propagation delay of the two NOR gates. If delay of the gate A is less, that means it acts faster than q is equal to 1. Else it is 0. Such dependence makes the job of a designer engineer difficult, as any replacement of a NOR gate will make q unpredictable. That's why r is equal to 1 and s is equal to 1 is forbidden. We use the word forbidden. Action is equal to forbidden and truth table entry is question mark. Truth table entry is question mark. It is also important to remember that TTL gate inputs are quite noise sensitive and therefore should never be left unconnected. Each input must be connected either to the output of a prior circuit or, if unused, to the ground or plus VCC. Now we are discussing about the NAND gate. With the help of NAND gate, we built the flip-flop. The circuit looks like this. This is the NAND gateless. Here we use the word R bar. This is your input R bar and this is your input S bar. R bar and S bar, we are using two NAND gate A and B, and this is your output Q and Q bar. A slightly different latch can be constructed by using NAND gate as shown in this figure. The truth table for this NAND gate latch is different from that for the NOR gate latch. This is your truth table. 1, 1, then last state 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, again question mark and forbidden condition. Again question mark and forbidden condition. We will call this latch as R bar S bar flip flop. This is known as R bar S bar flip flop. This is known as R bar S bar flip flop. To understand how this circuit functions, recall that a low and in any input to the NAND gate will force its output high. Hence, a low on the S bar input will set the latch, a low on the R bar input will reset the latch. The low in the S bar input reset the latch, the low in the R bar input then set the latch. So in this way, the flip flop will remain in its previous state. That means when both R bar and S bar are high, the flip flop will remain in its previous state. Setting both R bar and S bar low simultaneously is forbidden, since this force both Q and Q bar high. Both Q and Q bar high. In simplified way, we can see that this is your RS flip flop. This is your RS flip flop. This is the R. This is the S. This 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. These are the different pin diagram number. With the help of this NAND gate, this is your Q and this is your Q bar. This is the logic symbol for the RS flip-flop, R and S. If R is equal to 1, then reset the flip-flop. If S is equal to 1, then set the flip-flop. Same way, this is the truth table 0, 0. That means last state, what is your output? This is your output Q. This is your R. This is your S. 0, 0. Then last state 0, 1. That means 1. Reset the flip-flop. 1, 0. That means 0. Which reset the flip-flop, this set the flip-flop, and 1-1, that means question mark. 1-1, that means question mark, that means forbidden कंडीशन, दैट मीन्स फोरबिडन कंडीशन, दैट्स ऑल।